Hello everyone, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to talk about the transportation process that is happening across the eukaryotic cellular membranes. We know that the eukaryotic cellular membrane, the lipid bilayer, it has got its fluidity, that is the quasi-fluid type of nature. Because of this, it allows the movement of molecules across the membrane, that is in and out across the membrane. So this fluidity of the membrane, because of this fluidity, the cell can perform very important functions. What are the some of the important functions? These are the cellular growth, the secretions that is happening from the cells, and also cell divisions. And there are many other functions that is possible because of this fluidity nature or the fluid nature of this cellular membrane. Now this transportation across the membrane which we are talking about, it can happen by three different processes. What are these processes? Passive transport, osmosis, and third one is the active transport. Now let us look into how these transportation processes are happening. The first type of transport let us discuss about is the passive transport. So what is passive transport? This is a transport which is happening by simple diffusion process. Now what is diffusion process? Diffusion is the movement of molecules which can flow. So movement of molecules from higher concentration to a lower concentration. And very importantly, this process of diffusion or the passive transport do not require energy. Let us understand this with the help of an example. So here we can see that this is a lipid bilayer or the plasma membrane of the eukaryotic cells. These are some of the molecules which are present in very high concentration outside the cells, whereas in the cytoplasmic position, the molecules are absent. With time, some of the molecules are diffusing inside, and a time point is reached where these molecule concentration comes at equilibrium. So here the amount of molecule and amount of molecule present outside and inside the cell is almost similar, and they attain an equilibrium position. So this has happened only because of the simple process of diffusion from higher concentration to lower concentration, and there is no requirement of energy. The next process we are going to discuss is osmosis. Osmosis, this process occurs again by the process of diffusion, but the only difference from passive diffusion is that this happens through a semi-permeable membrane. Now we know what is semi-permeable membrane. These allow the movement of some of the selected molecules, and here in this case it is allowing the movement of the solvent molecules only, and it does not allow the movement of solute molecules. So in this picture we can see that the solvent level is almost same. The solute molecule concentration is less over here, whereas it is in very high concentration of solute molecules in this compartment. With time, what happens? The movement of solvent occurs from here to here. And see, after some time, what happens? The solvent concentration increases, whereas the solute concentration here remains the same. In both the compartments, the solute concentration becomes same, whereas the solvent concentration in this increases because the solute concentration happens is more over here. So the movement of solvent molecules across a semi-permeable membrane is basically the osmosis. And the third process is the active transport. This is absolutely different from the other two we have discussed because this is active and hence it is requiring energy. So here the movement of molecules occurs from lower concentration to higher concentration. That is opposite to the simple diffusion, because we know in simple diffusion, the movement happens from higher to lower concentration. Here, the movement will happen from lower to higher concentration, that is against the concentration gradient. So in order to move molecules against the concentration gradient, it will require energy. And in case of cells, the energy unit is the expense of, with the expense of ATP molecules. To understand, let us take this example. Here we are seeing two molecules. These red or the orange ones, these are the sodium molecules, whereas the yellow ones, these are the potassium molecules. Now, the concentration over here of the sodium molecules is quite larger, whereas the concentration of sodium is less over here. That it is reverse in case of potassium. Potassium is more over here and lesser over here. Now, these are the channel proteins, which actually help in the transport of these sodium and potassium channels. So, these are basically known as sodium-potassium channels. From this, we can understand the sodium concentration is higher on this area, whereas the potassium concentration higher on this part of the membrane. So what happens? These type of molecules or the protein channels, they hold this type of sodium molecules, and with the expense of energy, here you can see, with the expense of ATP molecules, what are they doing? They are forcing the movement of sodium molecules towards the higher concentration, that is from lower concentration to higher concentration. Similar thing is happening in case of potassium also. These channel proteins are holding this potassium, and with the expense of ATP, what happens is they are moving the molecules towards the higher concentration again. So this is happening against the concentration gradient, and it is requiring the use of energy. So they may pass through carrier proteins with the expense of energy. So this is the process of active transport. So in this process, in this video, we have talked about the transportation process that is happening in the cell membrane, eukaryotic cell membrane, and we have talked about three different types of transport, that is the passive transport, osmosis, and the active transport. I hope you have understood and liked this video. Thank you.